All right, Shalom. First and foremost, giving all praise to Yahweh Bashem, Yahweh Shai, Bahashem, Rachakwadash. Double honors to the elders and apostles of Great Millstone, who rule well. Peace and blessing to the hopeful elect. Shalom to the men of the Lord that are prophesying, preaching, and teaching on the highways and byways in sincerity and in truth. Shalom, Barakatham. It says, Putin says the West's attempt to have global dominance is coming to an end, and it is trying to cancel Russia with economic blitzkrieg of sanctions. All right, so the reason I brought this out, man, is because this is more evidence that we're in the year of Yahweh Bashem, Yahweh Shai turning up. You know, there's plenty of things in the news. You know, Esau's gonna try to distract you with this and that. I even heard the C-19 is reared its head back up in the news, you know, which they may try something again with that, but you know, all of this is to distract from the facts of what this guy Putin just said. And what he said is true. Even though they're both Edomites, you know, they're all going into slavery at the end of the day. But it says, Putin says the West's attempts to have global dominance is coming to an end. And when the West goes down, the whole thing is going down. All right. You Moabites are not next. You Ammonites, you Ishmaelites. All right. You Elamites, none of y'all are next, all right? Because when the West goes down, the kingdom is going to be set up, you know? And that's what these other nations don't get. That's why they're all are going to fight, because they have an interest in who wins the war, not realizing that there is no way for them to win. This is all prophecy basically unfolding, you know? And it's a beautiful thing that, you know, we're in the time to witness it, man, you know? You know, it says this first point here, Vladimir Putin says West's attempts to have global dominance coming to an end. He said that keeping Russia in check was a long-term policy of Western nations, right? Because this war has been brewing, man. When it says the second woe is past and the third woe cometh quickly, that was basically this world war, third world war, starting back in the Cold War era. You know, basically around the 50s when they were racing to make all of these nukes. That's basically when it started, you know, when they were racing to launch the first satellite, you know, and Esau, you know, did this whole scene about going to the moon and you know, there's just this Cold War back and forth, and it's all been swelling, all right, and festering and growing in tension, you know. Because the Most High is dramatic that way, you know. So the fact that we see that this place, the West, is going down is a sign that it's about to go down, because Russia and these other nations wouldn't have tried America even 20 years ago. They wouldn't have tried America, you know. 30 years ago, they definitely wouldn't have. Everybody was shook when America did the thing in Hiroshima and Nagasaki, man. All right, but now these other nations are emboldened, you know. I'm going to get that really quick, actually. Let's lock you. That was in Joel. That's the spirit. Actually, I already had Joel 3 pulled up. This is Joel 3:9, it says, proclaim ye this among the Gentiles, prepare war, wake up the mighty man, let all the men of war draw near. And that's what's been happening, all right, slowly, but now it's coming to that crescendo where things are happening in rapid succession now, you know. We're getting to a critical mass, man, you know. It says, let all the men of war draw near, let them come up, beat your plowshares into swords and your pruning hooks into spears. Let the weak say, I am strong, all right. So that's these other nations, man. Basically getting emboldened. And why are they getting emboldened? Because America is weakening. All right, they see an opening. They know, you know, you know Russia stepped on your shoe and you didn't say nothing. So now they know, oh, this nigga ain't, you know. Now they're trying to try him, okay? And this is all written, man. You can clearly see this is all in prophecy. That's why we get excited about it, man, you know. And it's a beautiful thing that we get to witness all of this in the month of March, which the month of March goes back to war, March is the month of war. That's what military campaigns happen. That's what the word march means. It goes into the word martial. All right. What an actual march is it's a military progression. All right. That's what a march is. That's what militaries do when they progress. It's called a march, and it goes back to the word, you know, Mars, which is the god of war. Also, it's named after the planet, you know, in Roman times, you know, the planet of Mars represented Ares in the Greek side, which was the god of war, you know. So that's where you get the term martial from. That's where you get the term march from, you know. It's all linked. So it's spiritual that all of this is happening basically at the beginning of March, man. That's when this whole thing popped off. It is in the month of March, you know, the same month as the Peshach, man, which we're gonna observe today, Lord's will, man. That we start seeing heavy signs, man. Joel, the second chapter, speaks about the signs that we would see, man. You know, pillars of smoke and people dreaming dreams and prophecies coming to brothers in visions. You know, Lord willing, man, we see that, because we're ready for this place to go down today. All right. But it's written right here, Joel 3:19. It says, Egypt shall be a desolation, and Edom shall be a desolate wilderness, for the violence against the children of Judah, because they have shed innocent blood in their land. So this links Egypt and Edom right there. We know that these two are linked in the last days. All right. So there's no hiding who you people are anymore. You know, it says, Russia says, told citizens they are fighting for our sovereignty and the future of our children. Latest in the propaganda pushed by Moscow as it seeks to justify its Ukraine war. And you know, both sides are wicked as hell, but you know, Russia has more reason to respond on what they've been doing, what these Americans have been doing, you know, this whole time, you know. Because we know Esau likes to pretend. He likes to throw rocks and hide his hand. He likes to pretend like he's in there for democracy, and he's there to free people, and the whole time he's robbing you, all right? And he's in strengthening himself and weakening you, or making you, or indebting him, or forcing you to be indebted to him, you know. Now you can see this map right here is pretty good, because it basically shows you what the West is. All right, you got these small countries. You got Japan, all the way down to Taiwan. All right, China's gonna take Taiwan, man. All right, and Japan was been demilitarized ever since, you know, 1945, after those bombs were dropped on them. You know, and you have Australia, New Zealand. These are Edomite colonies. All right. So South America is an Edomite colony here too, but they're not listed. You obviously have Europe. All right. But Sweden has decided to be neutral. They're like, we're not participating in any of this, because honestly, Sweden knows what's up. All right. And then you obviously have America over here with Canada included, you know, which is basically, you know, they were y'all the same people, man. You know, so that this is gonna be these NATO nations, man. This is basically the beast right here. All right, spread out, you know, militarily, but these are gonna be the nations that's gonna fight against these nations over here, man. All right, towards the east, and it's all gonna culminate right here in this land of Syria right here. I'll blow it up a little bit. The land of Syria is right here, right? That's where all of these nations are gonna fight. That's what we were reading in Joel 3. That's where they're gathering, the Valley of Decision, right here, man, on the Euphrates River. All right, and it's all gonna happen very, very, very quickly. All right, before you know it, you women that have been on TikTok twerking. Y'all are gonna be getting suited up on a 830 cargo jet. You know, they're gonna put your ass with a rifle and inside some MRAPs. They're gonna be putting y'all in tanks. Y'all not gonna be back in a desert in Nevada flying drones. No, y'all gonna be over there. All right. But going back to what this guy Putin said from Russia, that this global dominance is ending, man. This whole thing has been a strong spell of witchcraft over the planet, man. Because really, America's never really had economic power over you. Their real power has been with their military, really, because the dollar is bullshit. Now everybody's realizing it. Let's read Isaiah 25:7. It says, "And he will destroy in this mountain the face of the covering cast over all people, and the veil that is spread over all nations." That covering cast is Esau Edom, man. He's made you to believe that he's in charge, that he should be the one that decides whether or not you can do business with Russia, whether or not you can bank with them, trade with them, whether or not you have nukes. He decides what money gets allocated to you through the International Monetary Fund, through the World Bank. All right, he's dictating things to the World Health Organization. What are going to be your response to certain, you know, outbreaks? He's dictating it to all of these nations, and people are going to realize and be like, wait a minute. Why the hell are we listening to this guy? He's unreasonable. He's only looking out for himself. All right, and that's that's going to be culminated in Revelation 17:16, where it says, "These shall hate the whore," because the whore is really the one that's unruly. Yes, all these Edomites are wicked, but you got one that's going to be just wilding the hell out more than anybody, and that's what's going to cause this thing to pop. It says, verse 8, "He will swallow up death in victory." All right, the Lord Jehovah Bashi Miyahu Shai will wipe away all tears from off all faces, and the rebuke of his people shall he take away from off all the earth, for the Lord Jehovah had spoken it. So for y'all that say, how can you be excited about, you know, World War III, like you had that one Judite chick that was in the army crying, saying y'all being insensitive, you know, this is why, man. Because when this is what we wish for World War III to take place, regardless of what happens to us, because we understand that this is the Lord taking the rebuke from his people. And this is the kingdom being set up, all right? So this is a very, very important thing going on. You know, my last precept, this is Job 18:5. It says, "Yeah, the light of the wicked shall be put out, and the spark of his fire shall not shine." All right? So this light is being put out right now. All right? By your own people. And I'll get that real quick. As you read down, your own people are going to be the reason that your light gets put out. All right? That a world war is really a giant civil war, because it's going to be mainly Edomites, you know, doing a lot of the fighting. You're going to have Moab and Elam in there, but for the most part, this whole thing got started between who? Russia and America. Those are the two major powers that are starting this thing off in proxy, you know. All right, and it says the light shall be dark in this tabernacle, and his candle shall be put out with him. That goes back to the earth being made desolate. That goes back to Esau and Egypt being made desolate. All right. Well, we read in Joel 3, it says, "The steps of his strength shall be straightened, and his own counsel shall cast him down." Man, NATO's gonna be like, no. At a certain point, they're just gonna be like, hell no. And they're gonna turn on you. They're gonna see you, that you're the problem, and they're gonna shoot nukes on this place. All right. And you're starting to see the resistance right now with these sanctions being put on everybody, because it's gonna strangle Europe. You're seeing gas prices and the stuff go up here, and things about to rapidly inflate. This is about to be you in straits, man. All right. It says, "For he is cast into a net by his own feet, and he walketh upon a snare." All right. So this is his own doing, man. When Esau spread his nation, all going all the way back from the Greeks, when the Roman Empire spread across all throughout Europe, all of these nations are basically remnants of it, you know? Including Russia, but Russia is not a part of that fourth beast, though. You know, that's a very important distinction to make. But these Edomites, they got there and spread out all over there through the original Roman Empire, all right? So y'all are the same people, and now y'all are fighting against each other, man. You know, it says the djinn shall take him by the heel, and the robber shall prevail against him. The snare is laid for him in the ground, and a trap for him in the way. Terror shall make him afraid on every side, and shall drive him to his feet. All right, so this place is about to get heavily judged, heavily plagued, and we can't wait, man. You know, I'm tired of living and having to deal with bullshit every day, man. You ain't having to deal with work. You're stressing out over, you know, bullshit, trivial things. You know, food is whack. Women are out of order. The air is polluted. Just everything on every side is just vexing. So, you know, call halal Yahweh Bashim Yahweh Shai for prophesying and being able to understand it and to be able to witness it, you know, take place, man. So just wanted to bring that out for you brothers. Lord willing, y'all are edified. Call halal Yahweh Bashim Yahweh Shai Bahashem Rachak Wadash Wa Ababal Shalom.